Well, hello my beauties and welcome to my channel. Today, foundation review of the Estée Lauder Double Wear. So if you want to know what I think about this foundation, you just have to keep on watching. So guys, that's a little bit better. Estée Lauder Double Wear. I have a mini here. This is 15 milliliters and I got this, well, in summer actually. But I haven't really tried it until, well, just recently because I was looking for a foundation that would stay on my skin while I'm using Tretinoin. It does that. It stays really nicely. And yeah, I have mine in the color 3C2 Pebble. And yeah, the look I have on today, I did film, just so you know. And in a minute, I will show you the application. Then I will show you in natural light. I will try to do a wear test in the middle of the day. And otherwise, you will just see me at night when I'm ready to take everything off. But yeah, I have been using this foundation for about 2 weeks now. And yeah, I do like it. I do have to say that the weather has changed drastically now because it's really, well, a lot colder than it was a few days ago. Today is also really, really wet outside. It's nice Dutch fall weather. That means wind and rain, at least where I live. So I'm going to put it pretty extreme test, I think, today because it's just pouring outside. But yeah, the color is not really good for me. It's a little bit too dark. I do have to say, because this says C, I think it's cool toned. Now, my skin tone is neutral, bordering on yellow, at least in the summer. But it is actually kind of nice. So the color is not too bad. It's a bit too dark, but it doesn't really matter. And what else did I want to say? I wanted to say something, but I don't know what. Anyway, I do like the way that it's making my skin look. Do have to say my skin feels a bit dry at the moment, but that could be because I used a setting spray containing denatured alcohol. That could be it. But yeah, I'm just going to go about my day. I will show you the application in just a moment, and well, then the rest of the video will take place. Don't forget to check out my description box for all the makeup that I have on my face and all the rest of the information I have down there always. And yeah, let's just get into the rest of the video. Phew. Estée Lauder Double Wear. I'm actually kind of liking it, although I do have to say yesterday I wanted to film this as well and it really dried out my skin, but the weather is changing. So today is really rainy and I actually want to put it to the test. So what I did is my skincare and sunscreen. And on top of that, I plopped a little hydrating primer from Catrice. Let's try it with a beauty blender. So I just put some on here and yeah, it's probably too dark for me, but doesn't really matter. I'm just going to bounce it in and let's see how this does, because I kind of think that I get the nicest finish with a sponge, and this is a very thick formula. And what I noticed when I'm taking this off at night is that it really doesn't want to come off, to be honest. I double cleanse. I use micellar water first to, well, dissolve everything, take off the bulk of the makeup, and then I use a cleansing balm or cleansing oil or something like that. And you know, normally I can feel that the foundation is dissolving. And this one just doesn't want to come off. So once it sets, it sets. Which is good, because today it's just, well, Dutch autumn weather. And that means rain. And the funny thing is that I think this is more cool tone, the shade that I have, but it's actually not too bad. Yeah, it's a bit too dark, but overall the shade is nice. Let's bring it down just a little. And the funny thing is, I see now that if I use a sponge, the weird thing is that my brush soaks up more product than the sponge, which is kind of weird. But yeah, I think it looks very, very nice. Let me, do I need a little bit more? Let me plop a little bit more here. But to be honest, the finish for me is better. The coverage for me is better when I use a sponge. Just so you know. Let's plop a little bit more underneath the eyes to kind of save a bit of concealer. Well, usually I kind of need to powder it down a little bit, but I actually also do not really want to, so let's just see what it does today. I think it's looking nice. Yes, I'm shiny. And this probably because of the base that I put underneath. I really need to make sure that because the weather is changing, that I lock moisture into my skin, so the sunscreen I use is a bit more emollient and things like that. So I am a bit shiny, and I'm actually kind of curious to see what it does around my nose, because I made a boo-boo last week. I used the blood mask from The Ordinary, and I forgot to turn on the timer. But I'm also using tretinoin, and here around my nose, in the nose folds here, I just got peeling, which has never happened before. So I had a little bit of peeling and things like that. Now I kind of made sure that it is gone now, because I just put a lot of borage oil on it for a few days in a row, and that really helped. But I do have to say, if you have dry patches, or at least flaking, this clings. At least it did for me. Well, and it kind of tends to settle here in the smile lines. But I haven't found a foundation that doesn't do that. So yeah, it is still tacky. But again, that's probably also because of the base I have underneath. So let's get a little bit of powder. Let's use this one. Let's use what I like to use. So let me get the Catrice Extreme Blur Powder for underneath my eyes. This one is a little bit more fatty, if that makes any sense. And I kind of like that for underneath my eyes. So let me get a brush, tap out any creasing, and set. And I actually want to lightly set, because I want the emollientness, if that makes any sense, if that is a word, I don't know, from the foundation. I'm setting a little bit here because I don't like it when it's shiny there. I don't mind highlighted, but I don't like shiny. Okay, so that is that. And let me get another brush, powder brush, and just lightly set the rest of my face with the same powder. I'm just pressing it on. And I can still feel that it's tacky, because I used such a light layer of powder, it still needs to set more. So I'm going to let it do that. So let me zoom you in just a little, so you can see how it is looking. And I actually think it's looking kind of nice. So let me zoom you out again, like so. Let me see, oh, hair. Of course I have a hair. I'm going to let this, oh, settle a little into my skin. And to be honest, yes, the color is a little bit off if I look at my neck and my chest. The sweater I'm going to wear today, because it is just fall, weather is going to be high anyway, so it doesn't really matter. But I really like the way it looks right now. When I look in the mirror, I can still see my skin through, but it is looking nice. So yeah, it is starting to set here. Not so much here, so maybe I need to powder a little bit extra there. Just a tiny bit. Oh, let's use this one, doesn't really matter. And if my face gets dry, tends to get dry right here on this part. So yeah. How's the rest feeling? That's my head, so. But the rest has actually kind of sat. So yeah, it kind of feels set, so that is good. What I'm going to do now is the rest of my makeup. And let me check outside. Yeah, it is light outside, but not sunny. But what I will do is I will come back with everything on. I will show you what it looks like in natural light for as far as I can, because again, it is just really overcast here today. And then I will be back during the day and at the end of the evening to give you my final thoughts and see how it held up during, well, today's weather. So yeah, hold on tight, don't go anywhere. I will see you in just a moment. So everything is on and I did film this look, just so you know. Don't freak out. I was going for a soft neutral look and I think I kind of achieved it. But yeah, all the stuff I put on my face will be listed down in the description box below. And let me just check real quick how everything held up. Yeah. It is still, well, looking kind of nice. I do feel it's kind of drying already, which is kind of weird, but it is actually gone here. I don't know if you can see, so let me zoom you in a little. So that is what this foundation and a lot of other foundations do, is that it's just gone here. And I did set it. It's gone here as well. It is looking kind of cakey around my nose. Why do I have black on my nose? But yeah, this is actually how it is looking now. So let me just spray my face. I'll zoom you out again. Like that. Spray my face. Could also be the setting spray that's drying out my face. So I'm going to do this. And then I'm actually getting a hydrating priming base spray. Like so. It is again raining outside and the spray I have has hyaluronic acid in it. So I just want to pump it a little bit full of moisture. And because it is raining outside, it should kind of pull some moisture into my skin, I hope at least. What I'm going to do now is I'm going to open my curtains and then plop you in front of the window so you can see what it looks like in natural light. So hold on, I'll be right back. So I'm in front of the window now and it's really, really rainy outside, so okay. But this is what it's looking like now, so let me come in a little closer. I don't know if you can see this, but yeah, it is looking really pretty. it's not feeling drying at the moment, so that is good. And I hope it just, because it is raining so much, really locks in the moisture in my skin. But yeah, overall, I think it's looking nice. And I do know that it stays a really, really long time, but we will see how it holds up during this weather we have today. So yeah, next time you will see me is in a few hours, and I'm going to go about my day now, and yeah, again, see you in a few hours and give you an update, I hope. And otherwise, I will see you at the end of the day when I'm ready to take everything off. So yeah, see you later. So the final check-in of the Estée Lauder Double Wear. I have it on my face for about 12 hours and I'm ready to take it off. I will show you what the foundation is doing on my skin. So I'm going to take off my glasses. Going to zoom you in a little bit. Now, as you can see, my under eyes look really dry. They also feel really dry. I didn't put concealer underneath. I did powder it, but it's just, it also feels really, really dry. And what it's, of course, you cannot see it now. It's doing something weird here. And I don't know if it translates on camera, but it's like, I have a kind of a line here with kind of balling. And yeah, so when I swipe over it, it kind of balls up on itself and flakes off, if that makes sense. I have it on this side as well. Granted, I did eat, of course, but I don't eat like that, so I don't know what happened. Here, I still have a little bit of dry patches here on my nose, because I made the boo-boo with my peeling mask. And it is clinging to that. It also has broken up here a bit. I did blow my nose a few times, but usually if I do that, foundation rubs off all around here, and that's actually not what happened. It's just here. These spots are from my glasses, but there's still foundation on there. It's gone here, but that's because I was like this. So yeah, it has also rubbed off here a little bit, not too much. But when I look at my sweater, did it transfer? Well, not really. So that's good. So it didn't really transfer off. It probably just, I'm also doing this a lot. I can feel that I don't have any foundation here. I do feel it here. I didn't collect into lines here because it's actually not really in the lines there. But yeah, this part just feels really dry. It feels really powdery, and so yeah, it emphasizes the lines here, but that's just because that part of my face is really dry. When my face gets dehydrated, I feel it here first. So this part gets actually pretty dry sometimes. Itchy nose. Let me pull my mirror up a little closer and let's see what it is doing on my forehead. It is not really collecting into lines on my forehead, but maybe if I go like this, I hope you can see it. Maybe I need to turn down the light a little bit. Oh, that's probably a bit better, but it is not in my lines at all. So it hasn't collected in them, but it's just not there. So yeah, it is still on my nose. But yeah. So yeah, let me zoom you out again. Zip. Zwip, zwip. Yeah, it's actually a bit of a bummer. As I said in the beginning, I've been wearing this foundation for about 2 weeks now. I have been using other foundations in between as well, but for about 2 weeks. And the weather turned really cold yesterday, And before that, it was actually pretty warm here, especially for the time of year. We had like 20 degrees, 18 to 20 degrees Celsius, and that's warm for this time of year here. And yesterday it felt like it was freezing, so we had a big drop in temperature. Yesterday I noticed that my skin kind of got a little dry at the end of the day when I used this foundation. And today it's the same. So it's actually a shame because I was really liking this foundation and I was even thinking of buying the full size when my mini wore out or was empty. I'm going to wait because usually in winter time my skin is really dry, especially if I'm indoors a lot. Because we have central heating, and that the weird thing is, I live at the coast. We always have a high humidity here, even when it's cold, we still have moisture in the air. I live in a, well, it's not a new house, but it's not a really, really old house as well. But I always have a window open so my cats can go outside if they want to, and it's not really a dry house. So, yeah, the fact that when I'm indoors, my skin feels really tight. It's kind of weird. But then again, so am I. So yeah, I'm actually really bummed the way that this foundation is playing or not getting along with my skin in the last 2 days. It's really real a shame because again, I was really loving this foundation. So yeah, I'm not going to buy a full size anytime soon. I am, however, going to try and mix it in with some of my illuminating foundations because the illuminating foundations always really tend to rub off quite quickly. And maybe if I mix it, I can combat a little bit and make my perfect foundation. I don't know. I can also try using a hydrating primer mixed in. I can try all those things. I'm also really curious to see how my Superstay behaves now because I got a new shade. I got a lighter shade and it was also going great. But then again, the weather has really turned cold now. So I'm going to try that one out again as well. And I'm actually kind of curious to see how that one holds up. But for now, unfortunately, the Superstay is not playing nice with my skin. So I am glad that I always test out a foundation longer than just 1 day because if I would have based my entire review on today, I would have said, don't get it, it's not worth your money, or my money at least. If I would have done it the first day that I wore it, I would have been like, go get it because there's nothing better. So yeah, that is why I wear foundations for a week. For a week minimum, and yeah, see how my skin reacts a little bit. Now I know that how my skin is just affects the way a foundation is on top of it. That's just the way it is. And yeah, again, for now, I'm not going to buy the full size. Maybe this is a good one to wear in summertime because then my skin is a little bit more, I won't say oily, but let's say a bit less dry. Is it worth the money? You know, it's. I got this sample for €8, which isn't really too bad for a foundation, but then again, it's only 50 milliliters, so it was quite expensive. And I didn't mind that too much because I really wanted to try it. If I buy it in stores here, full price, it's about, I think, €50. And that is just too high a price for me for this foundation. Why? Because if I'm going to pay €50 for a foundation, me personally, I want a foundation that does it all. You know, that I can wear when my skin is drier, that I can wear without needing a concealer, that I can wear in summertime when my skin is less dry. So, yeah, but that is for me. And that's just also because my budget is small. That's just the way it is. Am I saying that you shouldn't go out and buy it? No, because I, for one, don't know your budget. Two, I don't know your skin type. I don't know what you like about a foundation. The only thing I can say is what it's doing for my skin. I find that my skin now is getting drier. With or without foundation, it's just getting drier. Maybe my skin needs to... how do you say that in English? Climatize to the weather change. That can be it. So I'm not writing off this foundation. I will mix it in with an illuminating foundation because I just want to see how well it plays with another foundation mixed in. If you have the Estée Lauder Double Wear, let me know down in the comment section below. I know there's also another one from the Double Wear line, which is a little bit lighter. If you have that one and you have normal to dry skin, let me know. And you know, let me know what is your favorite foundation if you have my skin type. So say normal to dry. What is your favorite foundation? Because, you know, if I'm thinking about paying up the money to buy Estée Lauder, Clinique is cheaper. I think even Urban Decay is cheaper. So, yeah. If you have a foundation, your favorite foundation, you know what? This is my question. What is your favorite foundation? List it down below. Also, let us know what your skin type is. And, yeah. Maybe I can get a sample of one of the foundations that you guys recommend. So yeah, that was my foundation review on the Estée Lauder Double Wear. Do I think it's worth my money? Not right now, no. And I'm actually quite bummed, but because again, the first day that I wore it, I was like, oh my lord, I know why it's everybody's favorite. And today and yesterday, I'm like, eh. This is not what I wanted. So yeah, I am not going to buy the full size anytime soon, but I'm not saying that you shouldn't. I do think that it stays really, really well. And yeah, it gives good coverage. Yes, it is a bit heavier feeling. I give you that. So if you don't like that, maybe you don't like the Superstay. What I would advise is if you are interested in the Estée Lauder Double Wear, see if you can get a sample first and see if you can get kind of a bigger sample. So not a really tiny one like this, just, you know, just a little bit, but see if you can get a little bit of a bigger sample so that you can try it at least two times, because I don't know if you can know if you like a foundation after just one try, if that makes any sense. So yeah, that's my advice. If you're interested in the Estée Lauder Double Wear or any other type of foundation, see if you can get something like this, so a travel size or a mini, or see if you can get a nice big sized sample, big enough so that you could wear it for a few days at least. That's my tip. And you know what you can always do if you get a very tiny sample in one store, go to another store and get another sample. I do that sometimes too. You know, if they're really cheap with their samples, and I, especially if I want to try, to really try something, sometimes, especially with foundations, you just need a bigger sample, then I go to different stores. And then I have the sample that I need. And then, yeah, you know, if I want it, I will pick the cheapest one. But that's how I shop. So yeah, let me know down in the comment section below what you think about this video. If you have the Estée Lauder Double Wear, and again, what your favorite foundation is. And then don't forget to also mention your skin type. And for once, you know, don't limit yourself to drugstore. So again, your favorite foundation, and while we're on the subject, also your favorite concealer. I'm still in the market for a good concealer, and my under eyes are dryish, just so you know. Oh yeah, and this was it for me for the review of the Estée Lauder Double Wear on a, well, dryish 42-year-old skin. If you like the video, give it a thumbs up. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them down in the comment section below. If you haven't already subscribed, just click the red button. You know you want to. Yes, because you know I can do this with my sweater. Like this. And I can be a turtle. Or Kenny. Or something like that. Or, yeah. I can just do that knot anymore. Anyway, never mind. While you're clicking buttons, make sure that you have clicked the bell. I don't know if it is working because YouTube is still doing weird things, which is really, really annoying. But yeah, oh yeah, a little household message. If you leave a comment underneath one of my videos, I always comment back. Just so you know, I always comment back. Why am I saying this? Because YouTube is doing something in which if I leave a comment underneath someone's video and they reply to me, I don't get a notification of that one. So I do see it if a comment is hearted, and then I need to go back to the video and then I can see that they have replied. So if you have left a comment underneath my video and thought, huh, she didn't reply, I did. I really, really did, because I always do, just so you know. And yeah, if I have commented underneath one of your videos, you have replied and I have not replied back, it is just because I haven't gotten the notification that you replied back to me, if that makes any sense. So YouTube, please fix that, because it's really, really annoying. Anyway, this was it again. Yes, again. I'm going to stop talking now. I am signing off. I'm going to take off all this makeup and apply my skincare and go watch YouTube, because I'm way behind again. So yeah, I wish you all a great, great day or great evening, depending on where you live and when you are watching this. And I hope to see you in my next one very, very soon. Have a great day, a great night. Bye, guys.